Hello, I'm a Swami Jaririta, lecturer in mythology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. So, Sikhs are rare to find. Turban and beard doesn't make you a Sikh. It's a culture. Nothing to do with Sikhism. So don't be mistaken. Sikh is known by what comes out of his mouth. Sikh stands for a student, Talmidim, which Jesus used to have. And they were solitary. And so are Sikhs to be solitary. Otherwise they are not Sikh. They are just stooges of the sons of Satan. Here I am rendering exposition of Mark 10, verse 17 to 30. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. Delivered by the first anointed Christ, which in Punjabi we call SATGUR Jesus, according to St. Mark 10, 17 to 30. As Jesus was setting out on a journey, a man ran up, knelt down before him and asked him, "Good teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life?" Jesus answered him, "Why do you call me good? No one is good and God alone." Now here Jesus wanted to tell people that we should humble ourselves. We should not have any pride in us. People who are good, sometimes they have pride in them. And pride is a stumbling block to the royal kingdom of God. You know the commandments: you shall not kill, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not steal, you shall not bear false witness. That means at the time of Jesus, people were giving false witness against their heart. Today is quite, common. You shall not defraud, honor your father and your mother. He replied and said to him, "Teacher, all of these I have observed from my youth." Jesus, looking at him, loved him and said to him, "You are lacking in one thing. Go sell what you have and give to the poor, and you shall have treasures in heaven. Then come, join me," not follow. Blind people follow others. Men, those who are not blind, they don't follow. They know their way. They are seekers. Once more, people are followers, are blind. Twice more, people are seekers. And this person being rich was twice born, because if he was once born, he would not have been rich. And not follow me as a blind. At that statement, his face fell and he went away sad, for he had many treasures, many possessions. Jesus looked around and said to his twice born brethren, and not the once born. Once born are disciples, of the rabbis. "How hard it is for those who have wealth to enter the royal kingdom of God. They acquired wealth by by cheating and other malpractices, such as lending money at high interest rate and so, easy money, not hard work. Could Queen, the head of Church of England, enter the royal kingdom of God? His brethren, you know, the Queen is the head of the Church of England, and if she can't enter the royal kingdom of God herself, how his people will do it? Or she the defender of faith? Defender of faith in which? Mammon or God? Mammon. And you can see how stupid people are, you know. And when I tell them that Church of England is Church of Satan, because how can you glorify soldiers who died in World War I, World War II in the name of God? No way. In the name of God we serve, as the Salvation Army people do, and not kill. His brethren and not the disciples were amazed at his word. So Jesus again said to them in reply, brethren and not children, you know, because if they call children, then they will make Jesus as father. So and then in the name of Jesus, the priest in the Orthodox Church, they call themselves father, as Jesus I called children they called them disciples. Jesus had no disciples. How hard it is to enter the royal kingdom of God. It is easier for a camel to pass through the eye of a needle by submitting to the will of his master or in humbleness than for one who is rich and proud to enter the royal kingdom of God, which is mammon free. First Church of God was formed, people sold their properties to join to form a mammon free community. And remember that camel, by submitting to the will of his master, who is a man, and he can pass through the eye of a needle. What about us if we submit to the will of our supernatural Father God? We will be able to pass through the eye of the needle or the narrow gate to enter into the royal kingdom of God, where our Father is. So this is the royal kingdom of God with narrow gate. Royal kingdom of God with narrow gate, the true vine planted by our fathers in the royal vineyard of our father. And here you get 100%. Here you get 0, 30, and 60. And here you get 100%. Perfect. At Pentecost, the father asked the foreman, Christ Jesus, to present his laborers. When he presented them, they were rewarded the same Holy Spirit with capital S, which is 100% fruit. As the first Church of God was formed, they were exceedingly astonished and said among themselves, then who can be saved? Jesus looked at them and said, for human beings it is impossible, but not for God. All things are possible for God. Peter began to say to him, Peter was once born, you know, and he was like a child asking question, you know, as a child asks a question to his father, you know, same way, you know, he was asking question to our anointed elder brother Jesus. We have given up everything and followed you. Peter was once born, he followed Jesus, seeing miracles that astonished him. Jesus said, "Amen, I say to you, there is no one who has given up house or brothers or sisters or mother or father or children or lands for my sake and for the sake of the gospel who will not receive 100 times more now in this present dark age. Houses, brothers and sisters and mother and children and lands with persecutions and eternal life in the age to come." Now you know this age to come is going to be all of saints. Their reward for the hard labor was Holy Spirit at Pentecost, and that is 100% fruit at Pentecost. When they received the very Spirit of God, they became twin brother of Jesus. All the 12 became the twin brethren of Jesus. So they were the inner circle laborers. The outer circle laborers, they were being trained for John the Baptist. 70 outer circle laborers trained here. Inner circle, 12 trained for this ministry of the royal kingdom of God. So our Father God blesses you, and the gospel is as simple as ABC. If you can think logically, the end product of logical reasoning is logo, and logo is his word, and that will settle here, because you have to do logo, logical reasoning yourself. I can't do it for you. I can only show you how to do it. But you have to do it yourself, practice it yourself to get gospel written over your heart. So gospel cannot be written down in ink on paper. That is from scripture, and scripture are Jewish leaven. Remember the Jewish scripture, you know, they were reading in the synagogue, dead letters, without understanding. But whenever Jesus taught them in the synagogue, he explained to them from the very basic roots, and that astonished them. That basic roots you can only get with the knowledge of oral Torah, which is his word, and that was missing among the Jewish rabbis. So Jesus came to fulfill the law and not to destroy it. Whereas the Samaritan rabbis, they had the knowledge of the oral Torah as well as the written Torah. They did not alter it. So anybody who find their books, you know, they are true. The Jewish books have been corrupted. The old cloth had 12 holes in it. The new, brand new cloth is gospel. So if you find any scripture of the Samaritans, they are useful. You should read that one, and you will get some information, true information. Whereas the Jewish people, they have corrupted it. They have corrupted even the New Testament when they entered the church by jumping over the wall and not through the proper gate. And then they altered the whole situation. Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45 is fulfilled among them. Our Father God, bless you.